Hello friends, welcome to Swara Sweet Delights. It's summer season and it's mango season, so today I'm going to show you a recipe using mangoes and we will be making eggless mango cake. And like always, today we'll be making it without oven, and the recipe is super easy as it does not contain any condensed milk or any curd or yogurt. It's very simple, so let's begin with this recipe. Let's see the ingredients for this easy mango cake, which is eggless. Here we have 1 cup of all-purpose flour or maida, 1/2 cup of powdered sugar, 1/4 cup of oil, and this is neutral flavor oil. It does not have any flavor of its own. Here I am using rice bran oil. You can also use sunflower oil. And here we have mango puree. I have just pureed a mango into mixie, and this is the pulp of that. This is 1/2 cup. And you can make use of any variety of mangoes. Here is milk. Milk we will take as required. Then here we have baking powder, 1 teaspoon. Baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon. This is mango essence. This is 1/2 teaspoon. If you don't get mango essence, you can make use of vanilla essence. And here is salt. 2 pinches of salt for taste. And here in this recipe, instead of oil, you can also make use of melted butter. For cake decoration, here we have heavy whipping cream. This will need as required. And here is mango pulp or mango puree. And in case if you don't get mango pulp, you can also make use of amras or mango jam or mango crush. There are many brands available in market like Mapro and all. They are good brands for mango crush. Here I have taken fresh mango pulp, and this is mango for decoration. Those who have seen my previous videos, they know very well that I normally bake in this aluminium vessel and I do ovenless baking. And here is a big aluminium vessel, and inside I have placed one ring or stand, and we are just going to preheat this vessel on medium flame for 10 minutes. Similarly, as we preheat our oven, here I took one bowl. And on that I placed one seed, and first we will just sift our dry ingredients. To this I'll be adding maida or all purpose flour, then baking powder and baking soda. Also we will be adding salt, and we will just sift this all together. Now here I've sifted this flour, and I've sifted it 3 times. You can sift it more than one time to make the cake more spongier and lighter. Now here I have taken another bowl, and to that we will be adding oil and sugar, powdered sugar. Here goes oil, and next we will be adding powdered sugar. And now we will just mix this well. We have to cream this mixture. Here I have taken one round cake tin. And this is an aluminium cake tin. This is 6 inches cake tin, and I have lined it with parchment paper. I have greased it with little butter, and then I have put one parchment paper. And instead of adding this, you can also grease it with little butter or oil and dust some dry flour. Now here our mixture is ready. You can see, nice and creamy. And to this now we'll be adding mango essence. And again we'll mix it well. After adding essence, we'll be adding our mango puree to it, and again we will just mix it well. You can see here the mixture is ready, and now it's time to add dry flour to it. We will add dry flour in batches, the sifted flour. And here one thing very important is we need to do cut and fold method. We need to mix it using a spatula or spoon and not by whisking it. We'll do this process until all the flour gets incorporated well. You can see the batter here, it is thick. And now to this we'll be adding milk. But milk will add only little. First I'll add only 2 tablespoons. and we will mix this well. You can see the batter consistency. I'll add one more tablespoon of milk to it. And again we will mix this well. The cake batter is ready and you can also see the consistency. You can see it is neither flowing and nor it is too thick. Now here we have our cake tin ready and we'll be transferring this batter to the cake tin. We have added the batter and I'll just shake this cake tin so that the batter is spreaded evenly, and I'll also just give a gentle tap so that there won't be any air bubbles. Our cake is ready for baking now, and you can bake it in oven also. You can bake it at 180 degrees for 30 minutes, but right now we'll be baking it into aluminium vessel. It's been 10 minutes since this vessel has been preheating. It's hot, and now we'll just place this cake tin inside, and again we will cover this with lid and we will bake it for 30 minutes on very low flame. It's been 30 minutes now and we will just check the cake. We will open the lid. You can see, I'll just close up it and I'll show you. I'll just insert the skewer in between. The skewer has come out clean and the cake is baked perfectly. We will let this cake cool completely before unmolding. Here the cake is cooled completely and now we will just unmold it. But before unmolding, make sure to loosen the sides. We'll just place a plate. You can see how easily it got unmolded. Just take this parchment paper off. And you can see how nice the sponge is. Spongy cake. It bounces back. You can see, nice. You can have this cake like that or you can decorate it. Right now I'm going to decorate it. Now here we have this cake and we will slice it into parts. Now this slightly dome part I'm going to take off . I'm doing it with the help of serrated knife . You can see this uneven part I'm going to take it off like this . You can see the sponge of the cake . Again for this part we will cut it into 3 to 4 slices. You can see here we have taken out one slice and similarly we will cut more slices. Be very gentle while handling it. All our slices are ready. You can see here. Here I took a bowl filled with 1/4 cup of water and to that we will be adding this mango pulp. And instead of doing this, you can directly make use of mango fruity. This we are preparing the solution. Instead of sugar water solution, we are preparing this mango solution or mango juice to moist our cake. Now we will just soak it with this mango juice. And with the help of knife, we will just spread it evenly. Now on top of this, we'll be adding cream, layer of cream, and we'll just spread it evenly. We'll add other layers now. We'll add our next layer. And again, we will repeat the process. We will just soak it with mango juice. Now we will also cover the sides. First we will make a crumb coat. You can see here we have evened out the sides and the top. And now we will keep this in fridge for some time for setting. Now we will transfer this cake to this cake board. and be very careful while transferring it. Now here at the center of the cake, I'm just going to use some mango slices and I'm going to make one flower. I'll try to make one flower using this slices. You can see I've cut the slices like this, and now we'll just try to make a rose out of it. Be very gentle while doing this. You can decorate the cake as you wish. Now here to a piping bag I added some cream, and to this I'll be adding very little of this mango pulp, and we will mix this both very well. Now here this mango cream I added to one nozzle to another piping bag, and this part I'm just going to fill it. You can do any design of your choice. We'll make border at the bottom. Here our mango cake is ready, which is eggless and without oven. And the recipe is super easy. It is made without condensed milk and without yogurt. So please do give it a try for this simple recipe. Please share this recipe, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel.